if you need to create something that will automatically order stuff without VBA, there's one way to do it. So here I've got some salespeople, they're the total sales. I'd like to see them from 1st to 7th. So the first function over here I need to use is something called rank. And you'll see all it says is where's the number. So I'm going to say look at their total sales and compare it to the other people's total sales. I'm going to put my dollar signs on. I'm going to say okay. When I copy it down, you'll see I've got the ranks, and now I can use a VLOOKUP. I'm going to say lookup. You'll see I've put some helper and helper column here. So I'm going to say look at the first person in this list over here. Put my dollar signs on. What column to use? I'm going to say just pull up whatever you see in there. Just going to put the dollar sign on the number, and over here I must just remember to put the dollar sign on the letter. Range lookup, I'm going to say false, and when I say okay, it gives me Jane, which is great. I can copy it across. It's putting through Jane's figures, no problem. Copy it down. Here's the problem. Two of these people are equally ranked, and as a result Excel can't handle that. So what we need to do is put in a unique identifier. So in this case, I'm going to just put a very small number, 0.1234. So just a very small number, just to make my life easier. I'm just going to do that. And then I'm going to say, take whatever I was going to use as the rank, just add that on. So none of these will affect the actual numbers. They're very small numbers, but Excel will notice it. I'm going to come here and tell it, rather don't look at this. Rather, please look at that over there. So I'm just moving these two. When I copy and paste it, you'll notice now that these are different. And as a result, Excel can now handle it. So if you're going to use this method to automatic sort, just remember you have to have some sort of uniqueness built into the ranking.